To be honest, when I come into these IG lives, I don't really have any topic in mind. It's just whatever we feel to talk about. And so, what do you guys want to talk about? I'll just do it really quickly. I have something in mind now, which I think I'd like to share, but it's kind of curious what you guys think. First of all, you guys are all subscribed to the IG channel and our YouTube channel, My Investing Club, over the YouTube channel. And if you guys watch those videos, do me a favor. Do us a favor and just click the like button, please. And we really never ask people to click the like. Like, if you see our stuff on IG Live, the post, just do us a favor, just click like. You know, that way we can see who's actually watching and liking this, and then maybe it'll actually help us push us up higher so that our videos get pushed instead of these gurus. These gurus are being pushed because they're asking people to click on like and all that stuff. And we never really do it, but why not, right, guys? I mean, I don't want to see their fucking ugly faces. You want to see up my ugly face, right? But at least we have content. I have a good personality. We actually teach you how to trade for real and not pump and dumping your crap, right? So do us a favor, click like, subscribe, and hopefully the algos will push us up so that you don't see all these other pump and dump gurus ads and all that stuff, guys. And come to Tosh's webinar tomorrow. I forgot, we're supposed to give away $500. We didn't do that yet. So do me a favor, go and click like, subscribe, all this stuff. And then whoever comes into the YouTube live webinar tomorrow that Tosh is hosting at 2 p.m. market time on Wednesday, we're gonna get 5 random people. We're gonna randomly pick someone. Who the hell does that, right, guys? These guys are making so much money pumping and dumping off of sheep and shit, and they still continue to rape. But I just decided to do something fun for the holidays. 5 people, get $100 each, guys. So tomorrow, you have to be present to win. I'm sorry. Make a little time out. Tomorrow at 2 p.m., Tosh's webinar. Are you there, Tosh? You can post some information. If you want more information, you can text Tosh as well. But you know what? Come in. Simple as that, guys. We're going to announce the winners tomorrow. We're going to randomly pick in front of everybody. People are asking, how did it not let you go to my head when I'm winning? The first thing you gotta do is to win, guys. Yeah, I hope you're winning, because if you're winning, the answers answer itself. So some of these questions, you guys are focused on the wrong thing, guys. Focus on getting there. Getting there is very difficult. You know what? Even more difficult than getting there? Staying there. So that's what I wanted to talk about today. Getting there is ridiculously hard already. But staying there, I guarantee you, is even harder. To maintain what you're doing consistently over time and not have to break discipline. Because the smartest traders, guys, are not necessarily the best traders. The best traders are the most disciplined traders. So keep that in mind. It doesn't fucking matter if you went to Harvard, MIT, Yale, Stanford, doesn't fucking matter. You can go to community college, and if you have the discipline, you can go to no college. You don't even need to graduate high school, but if you can follow our blueprint, our strategy, guys, you will make money, I guarantee you. Our strategies work. Our process works. It's up to the individual trader that fucks everything up, guys. I swear. Some of the best traders in the world, they're fucking idiots. You're like, how the hell they trade so well? That's because they're disciplined. They follow their process, and you know, in actuality, guys, I prefer to teach guys that are not fooled themselves. If you think you're too smart, I don't want to fucking teach you, because you're not going to listen. That's how most people are. They think they're better. I've had guys that join MIC for years, and then they finally message me and say, Bao, you're right. I'm gonna stop doing what I'm doing and focus on the MIC process. And I'm like, what the fuck you been doing for 2 years, dude? So he's been, you know, they've been stubborn. They want to change. But what happens is this. The danger is when you break a rule, when you do what the hell you're doing, you get rewarded for it. When you get rewarded for bad actions, it becomes a habit. And that habit is very hard to unlearn. Just like drinking and driving, okay? I'm gonna compare trading to drinking and driving. The best drivers, not necessarily the ones that drive the fastest and all that stuff. It's the ones that just follow the rules of the road and they'll get there. But the ones that think they can beat the system. And so an example is like drinking and driving, man. Everybody, I mean, it sucks. I'm just telling you, everybody have probably drank and drove. Anybody that drinks have probably drove drunk once. And it's fucking scary. The first time you do it, you're scared. Because you're like, I'm going to get caught. I'm going to go to jail. I'm going to kill someone. I'm going to kill myself. I'm never doing this again. I'm so stupid. But then you get away with it a couple times. You're like, fuck. Maybe I'm going to keep doing it. But you know what, man? The risk reward is not worth it. The risk reward is not worth it. You can get away with it 9 out of 10 times. All you need to do is get caught once. Your life is destroyed. You either destroy your own life or you destroy someone else's life. And that's even worse. The guilt, you have to deal with that. Same thing with trading, guys. You're trading really well. For some reason, you get sloppy because you're arrogant or you're bored or you want to make more money. You're greedy. So then you stick your toe into the water like E-A-R-S-A-ears and you fucking blow up. Happens all the time. And you know who you hurt? Not necessarily yourself. Actually, I guarantee you, when you blow up an account, when you lose, when you're being stupid, you lose, I guarantee you, it's not you that is hurt. It's you have to explain to your wife, to your girlfriend, to your friend, to whoever, to yourself in the mirror, why am I so stupid? I knew I should not have gotten into that shit. I knew I should not break the zombie rule. I knew I should not short. I knew I should not be drinking and driving. And so when you're sitting in fucking jail, which is the equivalent to blowing up an account, because you drank and drove, broke a rule, like trading, all you think about is really not yourself, to be honest. The good guys never really think about themselves. They think about, I let people down. And so that's the hardest thing to get back, guys. It's the fact that you let people down. And so I don't know how to help anybody else. But I can help myself, because what happens is this. When you do stupid stuff, guys, this is where we have the trading accountability program, the TAP. And I'm gonna write this down. I'm gonna explain to you how, as a short seller, okay, we'll talk about longs a little bit. As a short seller, this is how people blow up. People blow up on day one low floats. Simple as that. Day one low floats that are breaking new highs. They stick their toe in the water, next thing they fucking blow up. And usually it's not, the first time you break a rule, it doesn't hurt you that much. But then when you look at your P&L, you're like, oh, I'm only down a little bit. And then you're like, okay, I'm gonna come back in, because they're not gonna fool me this time. It's always the second and third subsequent time that you get trapped, and that's why you blow up your account. So if you are a short seller, we talk about this all the time. It's boring as hell, guys, to wait for the low-hanging fruit. Wait for the broken stocks, to wait for stocks to top out. Boring as hell to make money consistently. Making money consistently is boring as hell. Same thing with being healthy individual. Working out every day. In the beginning, it's exciting because it's a challenge. But over time, you get bored as hell. You take it for granted. You take it for granted, it's bored as hell. And so, how do you cure that, guys? You know what? You cure it, in my opinion, by having a training accountability buddy. I'm not joking, guys. That was my secret all this time. So this answer is, how do I not get into my head? Because you know what? It gets into my head when I'm sitting around myself or when I'm surrounded by people that do not understand trading. Or, you know, and so let's say I make a couple thousand bucks a day and some of my friends only make that a month. And so, you know, you don't surround yourself with the right environment, that will get into your head. And so you surround yourself with Alex and whoever else in MIC, you become those kind of friends. You really don't need to show off anymore. Alex and I was talking about today. It was like, it's like, you know what, man? I'll be honest, truth. Like, MIC, you know, the revenues MIC comes in, we hardly take any money out of it. It's like chicken scratch money we take. You know, most of it gets reinvested for marketing to build infrastructure. It's not cheap to run a big community like that. You know, we're not here, as you notice, okay? The difference between us and every other community is this is our baby. I'm here every Tuesday. I'm sick right now. I'm still doing this IG live because I care. You know, Alex does it. He hasn't taken a day off and I don't know how long. That's because we truly care. And the fact we care, you know, because we care about outside more than us. And that's why, in my opinion, to become successful, you have to think outside more importantly than yourself. So, you have to, once again, you have to equate trading back to the real world, guys. Okay? If you want to be successful, I swear, it's not about fucking trying to fucking stick your little dick out and pretending you have a big penis because you have a giant P&L. Shit like that. It's dumb as shit. Because you're comparing yourself to a bunch of losers. Because you know what? Those guys are just fucking... You know, they're lacking somewhere else. I don't know what the fuck it is. I'm not going to say anything, but, you know, it's like, if you surround yourself with the people that know, everybody loves to brag, guys. Everybody loves to brag. And when you lose, it sucks. But if you fucking have a true group of friends that understand, there's no more ego. If you take a look at my IGs and stuff, and Alex, we don't post fancy shit. No, when I was young, I used to show off my cars and shit. We have a boatload of cars. You know, our lifestyle is okay. But you don't see us posting shit like that anymore. You know, all you see is me walking around the fucking pond and helping people. Because that's how, that answers your question. How do I keep myself grounded? I keep myself grounded by hanging out with grounded individuals. You surround yourself with the good people, you are bound to become good people. You surround yourself with successful, humble, nice people, you will get there. If you surround yourself with a bunch of assholes, braggarts, showing off motherfuckers, revenge trading motherfuckers, scammers, pump and dumpers, doesn't matter what it is, you will become one of them. Remember what they say? You are basically the average of your fucking friends, right? You're the average of the three of the four friends, whatever the quote may be. But it's true. If you're hanging around a bunch of fucking losers who are fucking doing nothing with their life, you will become that kind of person. If you hang out with a bunch of nerds, you will become a fucking nerd. So you basically pick who you want to hang out with. And that's why MIC, in my opinion, I spend my time, Alex spends our time in there. So whatever new friends we have is from the MIC room. Like, I didn't know Alex well until MIC. Same thing with Tosh. Same thing with all the moderators. So how do I keep myself grounded? By hanging out with the good people. Notice the culture of MIC is so different. We don't sit and we don't fucking, you know, we make money and we don't go, bam, I made money, I'm fucking good. You see, I came back from a fucking $2 million loss, I'm the fucking man. That was the biggest day ever. Yeah, I was down fucking $100 million and now I'm fucking broke even. Yeah, I'm fucking good. You know, that's the sort of fucking attitude that it will fucking kill you if you hang around with those people like that. Okay? It's like, that's not realistic of how you fucking do it, guys. You know, there's really no reason to be bragging about that. You shouldn't be fucking losing. So, once again, it comes back to, I'm going to talk about this, man. Those guys, they do whatever they want. They've been trading for a long time. I guarantee you, they're not producing from scratch, homegrown, successful, consistent day traders with a good heart. They are stuck in the revenge trading, and one day it will bite everybody in the fucking ass. I guarantee you. You do not have enough money to come back from this shit. Who the fuck could be down hundreds of thousands, $1 million, and still be okay to keep trading? You know, all it takes is one event where the stock does not fucking ever go down and you fucking blow up. I know a fucking market maker guy. I'm not gonna mention names. He kind of learned from me too. Yeah, losing $15 million. $15 million, you know? And he blew up the firm. Because, you know what? Those guys have infinite buying power. All that kind of shit. But then it only takes one. So he's been fucking successful for 15 years at that firm. 15 years as I know him. But all it took was one for the bankrupt of the firm. You know, and as a new trader, but the thing is, it's fine. It's completely fine. He's not here trying to teach people to trade. It's work. Shit happens at his work. I'm only upset is because educators are teaching the wrong shit to people. And I would fucking stand here and debate with those motherfuckers any fucking day of the week how to properly fucking teach someone to trade. You know, the presidential debates, maybe we should have a guru debate. I will be up there with Alex and we will fucking talk about the proper way to teach someone to trade. People say there's no right and wrong. There's a wrong way. There may not be the ultimate right, but I guarantee you there's a wrong way to do it, guys. First of all, I'm not gonna talk much. I'm just kind of sick. I didn't know what to talk about, but I'm seeing all these guys just post this week, like they're bragging, bam, wham, I'm making money, I'm the best. I was down this and I made it back. I'm like, motherfucker, what about your fucking people? Your responsibility now is to your fucking people, not to you anymore, dude. Like, look at me. I'm fucking sick, man. And you know what, man? It's Tuesday. It's my time to do IG Live, and I'm looking forward to talking to you guys. Because this is what's helping me as well, to educate people like this. Because all week, I'm listening to all these motherfuckers brag about stupid shit. The best day of my life, best moment. It's completely fine, guys, to brag and all that kind of shit. But when you're an educator, it's a completely different thing. Right? Each room has some sort of community environment. You know, this is like the Karate Kid. You got the Cobra Khans on one side, and you got me, Alex, and Mr. Miyagi, right? So that's exactly what it is. You know, it's completely fine. If you want to be the Cobra Khan motherfuckers, go over there. I have no problem with that, guys. But do not come into our house and corrupt our people. That's it. I'm not bashing what they're doing, guys. I'm bashing how they're teaching and blowing up people. That's it, guys. You know, and as simple as this, none of those motherfuckers have done a meetup. You know why? They will get their ass whooped. Because you know what, man, they fucked people along the way to get to where they are. Ask yourself this: why am me and Alex the only one walking around, not scared of being beat up? Why are we the only one doing meetups? Some of these motherfuckers don't even post their real photos. Some of these motherfuckers, they fucking hide. We don't know anything about them. And yet, you're giving them money? Dumb, man. Some people are just stupid. People are trusting their life savings. Fallen people, they don't know who the fuck they are. All they know is a giant-ass P&L. Because you know what? I want you guys to all be successful, guys. We all fuck up, and when we fuck up, it's very simple. It comes down to a couple of things, okay? The first level of fuck up is when you don't know much. You don't know what you're doing, so you lose. Completely fine. And that's where education comes in. The second level of fuck up is this. Complacency. You get so fucking bored like I do. Seriously, I get so fucking bored, I start to fuck around on purpose. And then when I lose, I feel like shit. I'm like, why the fuck did I just do that kind of shit? That's because the money doesn't really mean much to me. But then you have to equate it to something else, right? But then that's the check and balances in life, guys. The check and balance in life is this. Sometimes I need to take a fucking hit just to remind myself so that I don't fucking take the ultimate hit. You know, I still have the max loss. I still have all these fences to keep me in check. You know, if I lose fucking 10 grand, it's not gonna fucking hurt my life. It just fucking hurts my ego. And I feel like stupid shit for breaking rules, right? But that's why we have fucking risk management. And I'm hearing fucking, I don't want to debate some of these fuckers. They call risk management, man, one guy calls risk management training wheels. If you need a training wheel, then you fucking put a max loss in. You motherfucking conceited fuck. I made more money than you fucking ever would fucking ever believe, right? And I still fucking advocate and use it. But that's just the Cobra Khan. That's the Cobra Khan shit, you know? And, you know, we're here Mr. Miyagi, wax on, wax off kind of shit, right? So don't listen to them, guys, but if you do listen to them, it's completely fine. You will end up blowing up and coming back to MIC. I'm not fucking joking. We're the only ones that are pushing people away, actually. I don't give a fuck if you join, seriously. Because you know what? The people that want to get rich quick, the people that are arrogant, I don't want to teach them. I do not. That's why I block so much. I have like I think I have almost 1,800 blocks on Twitter. 1,800 blocks. I have more blocks than most people have followers. That's because, you know what, man? I don't block because I'm mad that they're fucking calling me all these names. I block so that they don't learn from me. They do not get to enjoy my humor, my jokes. They do not see my charts. I'm the only guy that posts charts every day on Twitter. People are reverse engineering what I'm fucking doing, and I don't really give a damn. And this is my giving back, and I've been doing this for over a decade. So, and it's just funny because sometimes, man, you just can't take it, guys, seriously. Today I just woke up, and then Alex and I was talking like, man, these guys got like huge ass followers, a lot of subs on YouTube. They're asking people to give them thumbs up. If I have 5,000 likes, I will keep on streaming. And I'm thinking, man, we've been doing this streaming shit for 2-3 years now, Alex, and we never once asked anybody to click a like button. Are we stupid? I've never once asked you guys to click a like button. But then it's kind of like, it didn't even fucking occur to me that maybe I should. Because what happens is this. Sometimes you cannot be too passive. MIC is guaranteed the best content on the fucking universe when it comes to trade. No one matches our content. In fact, the gurus, the other rooms are copying what we're doing. Straight up, copying. They're calling it a 10-30 rule now. Some motherfucker is using the word backstop. I created the term backstop. I created a certain terms on purpose, guys. You know, like recycling, shit like that. They're recycling, you know. That was me back in the day. So everything I create, like zombie rule, like we do, is so obscure that it's not, you can't Google this shit, because we invented it. Okay, so now they're using word backtop on that. But you know what, man? It's completely fine. I'm not here to stop anybody from learning. We just have to be better. The leader. We are the leader. But this is where we're doing wrong, and maybe this is how you can help us, guys. Maybe help us promote us. You're sick of these guys' videos. It's always showing up. Annoying ass videos. Annoying ass. So to get rid of them, help promote MIC. Click a fucking like. You guys watch the YouTube, why are you fucking liking more? Or just help to comment all these. Same thing with Instagram. You know? And that's one thing that I'm telling you. We can always do something better. Alex and I are just kind of stupid because we don't do this. Because we don't have to do it. We make money trading. We will make money regardless if you promote us or not. But sometimes we're stupid. So that is a negative thing about that. The arrogance that Alex and I have is, you know. So we are all arrogant in our own ways. I am arrogant in the sense of, I really don't like promoting. I don't like to ask for that kind of shit because I feel it's dirty. But at the same time, why the fuck not? Humble myself. Click a fucking like. Doesn't fucking ask me. These motherfuckers are begging for likes because you know what, man? Without streaming, some of these guys can never make a penny trading on their own. They have no process. They're still learning to trade, dude. We've been trading for over a decade. And I never started a room because I never thought I was good enough. Because you know why? Because I had to be responsible to teach people without them losing money and blaming me. The last thing I want to do is promote a stock and half the people make money and the other half blow up. And I'm a fucking good human being. I would fucking sit and I would fucking cry to myself. I feel so bad that I fucking hurt someone. But not on purpose. Never on purpose. Because someone lost because of something I did or something I said. And so until we figured out how to educate someone without hurting them, I could never have started this business. So along came Alex, and so now we don't alert. You know, traders now in the room become so fucking good because they were forced to learn. They are forced to do homework, guys. Like when I was going through school engineering, I hated some of these classes. I admit, I copied fucking homework. I copied homework every day from some nerd. Even though I was a nerd. But I didn't learn shit. And so, that's because I didn't want to learn that kind of crap. But as a day trader, you don't really want to learn this, guys. Do not copy people's homework. Copying someone's homework is copying their trades. Do not copy their trades. Learn how they got the trades. Anybody want to get on? I want to bring one split screen on. Before I go off, because I miss these, man. Who wants to get on? Just raise your hand. We'll help, talk, whoever. You can bash me. Actually, someone's skeptical. Anybody skeptical? Let's get on so we can have a rational conversation. That'd be good too. If not, okay, Henrik. There we go.
Yay.
Hey. Oh,
what's
man.
Going on? No hey. Way.
What's up, my friend?
Not much. 2 seconds. My girlfriend's studying right now, so I didn't expect this. But look, I'm on the live with her. Yo, what's up?
Hey, what's your name? Where are you from, man?
I'm Herrick. I'm from Ontario.
Oh, South yeah.
South of Toronto.
So tell us your story. What's going on? Are you a member? Are you trading? Or are you just kind of like looking around?
I've been training right now, probably 2 years now. I started last year, had some free content, so I went over it. But yeah, no, it's so surreal right now. Just kind of threw it out. But yeah, no, I did it. I did like a beta run last year to see kind of where my skill sets laid with it. But I realized my emotions took the best of me, so I took
a
break.
That's exactly what it is. But remember, this is the whole thing I talked about, man. It doesn't come down to anything but your discipline, your emotions, controlling that. Because you know what you need to do. You know what you need to do.
Exactly.
Right? We all need it. We're just stupid, right? We're just stupid.
Exactly. I think when you value the dollar a little bit more than the trade itself and what it presents itself, then it makes the decisions for you.
So you're in school? What's going on here?
No, I got I don't know if I can flip this around. There we go. Studying right now.
What are you studying? What program is that?
Oh, there we go. I lost you there for a second. I got trade zero. I got on it there, so I seen you guys promoting it, so it helped me out with the brokerage fees and things like that.
Have you you saw our YouTube channel?
Yeah, I have. I've gone through a lot of your videos there, so you guys are kind of like the filters there that help me see past the bullshit from other people, right?
Correct. Have you ever joined MIC, by the way?
No, I was actually just looking at your email. So, yeah, I'm thinking about it. Yeah. But the quality's there, right? Like,
I'll do this for you, brother. I'll do this for you. Only you, okay? Don't fucking DM me. I'll give you a free month just to fucking, because you're a fucking cool guy, man. So, hit up Tosh. Hit up Tosh.
Yeah.
Give you a free month, okay? Because you know what, man? You're the type of people. You're the type of person that we start MIC to do. When I talk to you, you're like, whoa, it's surreal. Look at this, my girlfriend. You know what I'm saying? You got really excited. You don't take shit. You don't take shit for fucking granted. You know, you appreciate everything. And that's the type of personality, I'm telling you, becomes a good trader. Because you know what, man? You're motivated. You're not arrogant. And you want this.
No. Yeah. I think it's being humble, right? And the market humbles you already. So the quicker you're to it, then the easier it'll be going on forward.
Seriously, man. But, So how old are you, man? You look like you're still in high school.
It's the genes, right? It's the Asian genes. I'm not 25.
25? You Hawaiian? You look Hawaiian.
A Filipino.
Sweet, brother. Henrik, huh? Cool. All right.
Yeah,
this is, you know, go ahead. Ask anything you want, man.
Yeah, honestly, like, I see the content that you guys have. I did my due diligence. I kind of filtered out all the bad gurus, seen who was putting out the proper content. And everything that you have lines up, right? It makes sense. It's more of, like, the discipline end of it. So all the content that you have,
do
all
this.
The free
do,
content,
do this.
YouTube, everything.
I will do this for you. So tomorrow, 2 p.m. Yeah. market time. Tosh has his YouTube. So go in there. When you go in there, when you see me, say hi. Okay?
Okay.
On YouTube, say, hey, this is the fucking guy from Ontario, right? This is my Asian brother from Ontario. I want you to watch that webinar, that's why. Because there's a lot of content in there, guys. And when you get there, I'll give you that free month, man.
Okay, 2 p.m. and then you want me to message Tosh then?
When you get in there, yep, just say, hey, you know.
Hey, perfect. The guy from Ontario.
Yep. Now, hey, you know what's funny? Tomorrow there's gonna be 10 guys from Ontario.
that they're all gonna be saying it, right? Gotta have like a little code name on it.
But seriously, man. Exactly, brother. You know?
Yeah. No, thanks again. There's a lot of fluff content. So the content that you're putting, when you actually apply it, when you actually look at the charts, you can actually see where these things play out, especially when you're looking at it live.
So are you working? What's the situation like up there?
I got a small little vinyl wrap company. So I do subcontracting through 3M. That's
Bio
kind of
wrap.
like the funding.
Like
Yeah, like
what?
vehicles and stuff like
Oh, vehicle wrap. That's cool. So if you're in Ontario right there, brother, look out
that.
for
Yeah,
car wrap.
exactly. There
But
you
you
go,
know,
if you ever
guys,
down this one.
you made my day, man. You know why? Because Alex and I was talking this morning. We're so fed up by all these bullshit because we think we're too nice. And sometimes, you know, man, when you're nice, you get shit on, right? And so
Yeah.
sometimes it takes, you know, I wanted to go. Alex goes, you know what, man, you're sick. Don't do the IG Live. I'm like, no, I have to see. Because IG Live makes me talk to people like yourself. And I can
Yeah.
see, like, the good that we're actually helping people. And
Yeah,
sometimes
it's
that's all we need.
crazy.
Because you know what, man, the numbers on the screen don't mean shit. Sometimes we're just
Nope.
like, fuck this shit, man. I just want to make money. Fuck you guys. Fuck everybody, right? But then I get on IG Live and I'm
Obviously.
like, I'm humbled again by people like yourself who like just want. Because I remember when I was there, man. When I was your age, when I was fucking had nothing, no one fucking helped me. No one fucking helped me.
Yeah,
So.
exactly. I come from a town of 4,000 people, so the mentality is really capped, so you have to really search so that you don't get stuck in those ruts. So it's
So
the
all
content
you
that you
guys,
guys
man, all you
put
guys are living. Just all I ever wanted from you, from anybody I help, right? Is when you make it, you only need to
Yeah.
make it. But when you get enough to help someone, help someone. That's it. You
Yeah.
know, pass on, pay it forward, brother. That's all we ever
Yes,
ask.
always.
He knows me. I don't ask for shit. I don't need anything. I just need a
Dude,
bunch
I'm
of good.
surprised.
I just need a good bunch of good people to change the fucking world, man. Because we can't do it alone, brother.
Yeah, no, and I appreciate it, right? That's your time, so it has to be respected at the end of the day.
So cool,
Biggest
man.
thing.
I'm gonna keep this short and
Cool.
sweet. It was
Yeah,
good
yeah, yeah.
meeting you. Tomorrow,
Good
guys,
meeting you.
2 p.m. Tosh's webinar, guys, 2 p.m. on YouTube, on
Perfect.
our YouTube Live. All right, man, go back to
Awesome.
sleep. Get out of
See
here,
you,
girl, for me.
pal.
All
Yeah,
right,
we'll
brother.
see ya.
Have a
Peace.
good one. All right.
You too.
Happy holidays. All right, guys. That's it, man. That basically made my day. I mean, he was so fucking appreciative. I'm like, dude, my heart just melts when I see like that. Because sometimes that's all you need, man. I'm gonna tell you something. I'm gonna leave it with this, guys, because it's Thanksgiving, the holidays coming up. Everybody thinks that they're in some shitty situation, but you know what? The fact that you're here listening means you're okay. There are so many people out there worse, wishing that they could be in your shoes. And what the fuck do we have to cry about? I'm sitting here crying because I don't have a bunch of likes on a fucking video. You know how stupid that is? Just an example. That's just one example. You're here because you're mad because you know what? You can't have a fucking like the new PlayStation or some shit. I don't know what it may be. Some people are just praying that they have food on the table. Some and you're fat. Let's say you're fat, overweight. You're pissed because you don't look good. There are people that wish they had legs so they can exercise. So get off your fucking ass like I'm doing and walk around and exercise because I got fat too. You see what I'm saying? Stop feeling sorry for yourself. Feel blessed. Every day we are blessed. Some people have COVID and are dead. Some people have COVID and are in the hospital, like one of my friends. So what I did was this, man. Remember? I posted it. I was like, fuck this shit. So my birthday's coming up, guys. December, mid-December. I was gonna take a trip to Hawaii or something. I was like, fuck, man. There are people that are more deserving and in need right now. So I gave my buddy $5,000 that I would have used to go to Hawaii. So now I'm gonna spend my fucking birthday helping guys at MIC instead of taking the week off. You know, and I'm feeling blessed already. Like, you know, that's the sort of stuff that you have to do, guys. You know, sometimes you have to motivate yourself and to realize how lucky you are. The moment, and so this is why you travel. I travel third world countries and I fucking realize it. And one thing that Kareem Abdul-Jabbar went on and said about, because it's Bruce Lee's birthday, 80th birthday, if he's alive, it was this week. It was Bruce Lee's 80th birthday. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar goes, you know what, man? Make friends with someone that does not look like you. That's it. go out, guys, and make friends that do not look like you. And you, your perspective on the world's forever changed. Alex is a completely different person than I am. Tosh is a completely person I am. I'm not just hanging out with people like myself. And by doing that, amazing shit happens, guys. Amazing shit happens. Your perspective on life completely changes because you know what, man? Everybody's different. Then you're going to realize how lucky you are to be where you are, guys, and to be blessed. With that, happy holidays, and I'll see you guys tomorrow at Tosh's webinar.